From my sponsor Siemens, I got an industrial grade servo motor with a control unit. I'm using this package to demonstrate the main differences between open and closed loop drives. To go into details, I've built two more drives from scratch. A bipolar stepper motor without sensor feedback, and a brushed DC motor with a rotary encoder on the shaft. The signals needed to control all three drives are generated by a Simatic IoT 2020. First, let's have a closer look at the bipolar stepper motor. The maximum phase current of this motor is 1.68 amps at 2.8 volts. The driver board is based on a LV8772 chip, capable of delivering a phase current of up to 2.5 amps. With the potentiometer on the board I have adjusted 420 mA, which is sufficient for this demonstration. The movement of the motor is controlled through two input pins. With two push buttons you can apply voltages to those inputs manually. If there is no voltage applied to the direction input and the button for steps is pushed shortly, the motor rotates clockwise for one step. The angle of rotation is ruled by the mechanical parameters of the used stepper motor. In a previous video I've demonstrated in detail how those motors work. The motor used here has a full step angle of 1.8 degrees. With the half step mode used by the driver board, 400 step pulses are needed for a full turn of 360 degrees. When having a close look you will notice that the rotation starts whenever the button is pushed, a step is triggered as soon as the input signal jumps from 0 to 5 volts. Nothing happens when releasing the button and so going back from 5 to 0 volts. If 5 volts are applied to the direction input by pressing the second button, and pushing the first button shortly, a rotation of one step in counterclockwise direction is triggered. Once again, the angle of rotation is 0.9 degrees per pulse in half step mode. In modern machines, the signals used to control stepper motors are not generated manually by pushing buttons, but by computers. Here I'm using a Simatic IoT 2020. With that single board computer I'm controlling the drive in such a way that the motor shaft does a full turn clockwise, followed by a full turn in counterclockwise direction after a delay of 3 seconds. If the rotation is stopped shortly by hand, the disc on the shaft no longer stops at the initial position. During movement of the motor, steps were lost. The software gets absolutely no feedback about the stalling of the drive and continues calculating steps as if nothing had happened. Losing steps has to be avoided when operating machines like 3D printers or CNC routers, because that's what ruins your workpiece. The torque of the used stepper motors must be sufficient to overcome the counter torque of the mechanics under all operation conditions. The motors I'm using in my home built CNC router have a holding torque of 101 Nm, which is enough to move all axes even under maximum load during operation. Using motors generating a more than adequate torque is a simple solution to avoid losing steps. More reliable, but also more complex to implement, are closed loop drives having sensors to detect rotation. To do so, there is a sensor disc attached to the shaft of the second motor. There are 10 holes at the edge, so that the rotation of the disc can be scanned by two light sensors. If the light sensors are blocked by the disc, the output of the sensors is 0 volts, both LEDs are turned off. As soon as light hits the photodetectors through a gap in the disc, the output jumps to 5 volts. Both LEDs are turned on. Depending on the position of the disk, the two outputs of the photosensors change between 4 different states. Whenever the disk rotates until one of the outputs of the photosensors changes, you can calculate the direction of movement. The angle of rotation is ruled by the number of teeth and gaps in the sensor disk. Whenever the disk rotates from one gap to the next, the state of the outputs changes 4 times. With a disk having 10 gaps, a full turn triggers 40 changes in output signals. One step equals a rotation of 9 degrees. You can learn more about that type of rotation sensor in a previous video. Take a note that you can't stop the non-powered DC motor used here at any position. Caused by the construction parameters, namely the number of permanent magnets and the number of poles on the armature, the motor shaft jumps back to certain positions when being released. With an H-bridge, the motor can be switched to rotate clockwise, as well as counterclockwise. When reading the signals of the photodetectors on the sensor disk, you can control the motor in such a way that the rotation stops at a given position. The signals coming from the photosensors and the external position command pins are read by a microcontroller type ATmega328P and so used to compute the control signals needed to switch the H-bridge. Same as with the bipolar stepper motor, two input pins on the control board rule the direction of rotation and the number of steps to move. First I'm using the push buttons to control the motor. When leaving the direction button open and pushing the step button shortly, the DC motor rotates clockwise until the state at one of the photodetectors changes. After that the motor is turned off and so stops moving at the given position. As shown before, the motor snaps to certain positions, so that it might go back a couple of degrees as soon as being powered off. The microcontroller can detect that movement and repowers the motor until the given position is reached again. That's why the motor oscillates around the set point at certain positions. If the disk is turned by hand, the microcontroller starts powering the motor through the H-bridge in such a way that this movement is counterbalanced and the shaft returns to the set point as soon as the disk is released. If the direction button is pushed while the step button is closed shortly, a counterclockwise rotation of one step is triggered. Same as the bipolar stepper motor, the DC motor can be controlled by the IoT2020. However, if the movement is blocked by hand, there are obviously no steps lost. The software running on the microcontroller compares the real position with the set point and continues processing step commands not until the needed rotation is detected. Still, the motor stops at the initial position. The closed loop drive prevents losing steps, however the needed electronics and software is more complex than with open loop systems that don't get any position feedback. So now let's have a look at the big drive. The motor is a brushless type, powered by 230V 3-phase alternating current. The electric input power is 0.75 kW, which is around 1 horsepower according to James Watt, clearly more than the modest 20 watts of the DC motor shown before. The built-in rotary encoder is clearly more sensitive than my disk, the two output lines deliver 10,000 pulses per full turn. The control unit is a Synemics V90 with pulse drain interface from Siemens. Same as with my home-built drives, the position of this industrial servo motor is controlled through two input pins, one for the direction and one for the number of steps. Additional input pins on the interface allow for example to turn the drive on and off, or you can implement end switches. With the IoT 2020 you can position the motor shaft exactly in the same way as I did with my self-made drives. You only have to step up the 5V of the GPIOs through transistors to 24V, a common logic level in industrial applications. Movement of the motor can be seen when having a very close look at the edge of the aluminum disc with a diameter of 140mm at an adjusted step width of at least 4 steps. With the 24V input pins I'm using here, the Synamics control unit can handle step pulses with a frequency of up to 200kHz. Through a second, high-speed input using 5V differential signals up to 1 MHz is possible. According to the base frequency the IoT 2020 generates, the motor now moves with constant speed. With that control mode you can drive several motors with constant speed synchronously. In contrast to my simple homemade electronics board, the Synamics control unit offers a couple of more modes to drive motors. For example through the arrow between setpoint and actual point, the torque acting on the motor shaft can be calculated by the Synamics. That enables you to drive the motor with constant torque. This mode is needed for example when driving a band conveyor using multiple motors to keep the load on the band constant between all drives. My demo console with the 3 drives has a built-in touchscreen being connected to a web server running on the IoT 2020. With that you can run all experiments shown in this video, have a try if you see my setup on a Maker Faire. Thanks for watching and I'll be back.